terrifying, startling suspense. Strange mysteries. March 1955, number 10, Superior Comic. 10 cents! All the names in this story are entirely fictitious, and no identification with actual persons is intended.
Murder!
Slay!
Torture!
Death!
Fiend!
Hate!
Murder!
Kill!
Revenge!
Revenge can be fatal. You can search through moldering antiquity, pore through grisly annals of crime, study shuddering records of monstrous, hellish terror, but nowhere in all creation will you ever find any hate that compares with the frenzied, soul-searing, mad hate of Dr. Zart! 20 years ago, Dr. Zart was the gentlest, the mildest of all creatures. Yet, one day while toiling in his laboratory, with his young, handsome assistant George Warren at his side, he sensed that something was amiss.
There's something troubling you, George. Come now, don't deny it. I can tell. Speak up, George. Maybe I can help.
You can help, Dr. Zart. By
dying!
Lying at the bottom of the huge chemical drainage bowl set into the floor of the laboratory, Dr. Zart found it hard to believe that the young man leering down at him was the same George Warren he had befriended and employed.
Help me! I injured my foot!
You have titch, titch! Now isn't that a pity? You can come in now, Ellen.
Ellen, help! Help! George has gone mad!
Listen to that gibbering fool, Ellen.
Isn't he dead yet?
Incredulously, Hugo Zart observed his assistant, whom he assumed to be his friend, romance his adored wife.
Kiss me hard, you little witch! Like you've done so often when the Honorable Doctor's back was turned.
Yes, honey. Yes. Yes!
My darling Ellen, whom I've trusted and worshipped, rubbing lips with that swine. No! No, it can't be!
It's you who are the swine. Fat one! You with your nauseating goodness. You with those pleading, innocent brown eyes.
Tell Hugo some more, Ellen, darling. Make him squirm.
I've hated your sweating hands for years, and you're a fat little animal, husband dear. And I despise you. I want a real man. A man I can love with all my heart. Someone hard and cruel and passionate like George.
Me.
Kiss me, George. On the neck, George.
Delighted.
Alternately raging and pleading.
Oh, please.
Dr. Zart painfully pulled himself up the steeply sloping, slippery interior of the huge drainage bowl, inch by inch.
I've got to get out. Reason with them. Ellen, my wife. George, my friend.
Have a kick in the teeth. Friend!
Oh! Bellowing like a wounded beast, Dr. Zart tumbled down into the bowl again.
Bye!
over this matter and it contains that new solvent Baxter was experimenting with.
No! Not the solvent! Not the...
While you die, Dr. Zart, think of Ellen and me enjoying a little love trip. And spending like water the money you scraped and pitched for years and put in your joint savings account!
Ellen and George left. Certain the moaning. Screaming. Zart was done for, but with a tenacious, almost human, super determination. A dripping horror crawled and flopped out of the bowl. A doctor living next door, attracted by inhuman screams.
Ah! Oh dear, oh dash over pain, at the pain, oh dear. There's still a flicker of life. There may still be a chance for this thing.
Weeks later.
I warn you, Zart. There's a limit to what even plastic surgery can do. What you see won't be very pretty. Maybe had to amputate your leg.
Give me that mirror and get out! Get out! Yay! Raging the vile horror smashed the mirror! I can't stand looking at the ghastly mess they call a face! I don't want to live. Sob.
But as Zart is about to end his existence, a thought strikes him.
No! I won't kill myself. Why should I? Ha! 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 There's something sweeter even than death for an obscenity like me. Revenge! Ha ha! Ha! Revenge on the brutal, cold-blooded monster who stole my Ellen and ruined my life!
Revenge!
Death!
Murder! Revenge! Revenge!
Donning a plastic mask to hide his horror features and replacing his lost leg with an artificial limb, Dr. Zart traces the fleeing duo to a hotel in a nearby city.
Soon, a vengeance. Ellen, your throat slit, dying! Ellen, it's Hugo!
Hugo? Alive?
Yes. George Warren did this to you, Ellen. Why?
Joy! Tired of me.
Yes.
Ran off with.
Yes, yes.
The rest of.
Yes, yes, yes.
The money.
Sob. Ellen, say you're sorry. Tell Hugo you repent your sin.
Sorry. Sorry to run away from the. It was worth it. You were here. I'd rather have George slit my throat 1,000 times than live 1 second with you.
My darling Ellen.
And so began one of the most relentless manhunts of all time, motivated by the mad hate of Dr. Zart! Dr. Zart trailed George Warren across the country, narrowly missing his opportunity for revenge at each twisting turn of fate, until, at last, the trail of vengeance led Hugo Zart, ironically, back to the very town where it all began.
Year after year, I was untiring in my chase, and now, at last, revenge!
Hey, what's up, Bullion?
Why is everyone so excited?
George Warren just dropped dead. A heart attack. Isn't it a shame? He was such a swell guy.
Oh my God. The shocking news rocked Zart with the force of an H-bomb. Despite himself, he began to chuckle wildly.
After all these years, I'm to be cheated of my vengeance. How ironic. How devilishly ironic.
He must be off his rocker.
But a man obsessed with the
mad hate of Dr. Zart!
A hate that would inflate into gigantic proportions through the years would stop at nothing for revenge!
So he thinks he can cheat Dr. Zart by sneaking off into the Valley of Death, does he? Well, I won't let him. Even if I have to tear him out of the talons of Satan himself, Dr. Hugo Zart will have his revenge!
Returning to his musty laboratory, the mad genius reconstructed an experiment he had almost completed years ago.
I'm confident it will work. Test tubes, wires, all I need is George Warren's body!
A spade. A moonlit night. And the grisly deed is done.
Coming with me, George.
In his laboratory, Dr. Zart administered life-reviving fluid into the corpse of his eternal foe. And waited.
His eyes opening.
Zart. Dr. Zart? What? Where am I?
In my laboratory, George Warren. I've succeeded in bringing you back from the dead!
But why have you brought me back to life? You, who hate me more than everyone else in all creation!
So I could have the supreme joy of killing you with my bare hands! Darling! For stealing Ellen from me!
George's throat. One of Warren's flailing hands closed on the scissors, and...
No! No! Not the scissors! Put it down! Ah!
Zart collapsed, and as he died, his last sight on Earth was the fiendish leer of his triumphant enemy.
Thanks for bringing me back to life, chump. So that I could kill you! Ha ha ha!
The Mad Egg of Dr. Zart had boomerang.